Hello everyone, I'm Alan. Today, let's quickly build a local chatbot based on large language model and retrieval augmented generation. Meta AI introduce RAG method to address the knowledge, intensive tasks. Here is the architecture of this application, and some components will be used. First, let's list the components. GPT for all for word embedding. LangChain is a framework for developing applications powered by language models. Chroma, a vector database, a llama, a large language model open sourced by Meta. Chainlit, a web application framework for chatbots. Now let's take a look at the application diagram. The left part involves the process of entering document data into the system. LangChain supports reading various types of documents. It's recommended to pre-process documents into a standardized format with a certain directory structure for easier handling during later KA processing. Various documents are transformed into text, and TextSplitter breaks them into chunks. Text embeddings are then processed, converting text data into vectors, and these vectors are saved to the vector database. This process allows us to handle natural language processing of private and confidential documents locally without exposing them externally. The right part involves the QA process of the chatbot. When users visit the chatbot webpage, the bot displays a greeting message for users to ask questions. User questions undergo pre-processing, involving word embedding to generate one or more vectors. These vectors are then used for semantic search in the vector database, typically involving similarity searches using algorithms like KNN or cosine similarity. The search results are passed to a large language model for further processing. The large language model will perform some processing based on the database's returned results, primarily in two parts. If the database yields results, it will undergo predetermined processing, such as making the responses more personalized. If no results are obtained, there's an option to either let the large language model generate a response or use predefined results. The entire process is integrated using LangChain, which provides high-level components for this flow, chaining interface and LangChain expression language. In this case, a predefined QA chain is used for the entire conversation. Chaining is a quite powerful component. We can query multiple databases, retrieve multiple documents, link various large language models, and synthesize a variety of returned results. LangChain handles the main backend business logic, while Chainlit completes all the interaction logic. Moving on to the setup and code execution, let's start by introducing the configuration. A Linux environment and Python 3 are required. We use Miniconda to manage the virtual Python environment. We are using LLM. For instructions on how to install LLM, please refer to my previous video. To ensure fast processing, we are utilizing an NVIDIA GPU, and it's necessary to install the relevant drivers and support packages. I've listed the required Python packages in the requirements text file. I've also downloaded some content about sports injuries from the internet and saved it in a PDF file. Let me quickly browse through this content. Now, let's take a look at the code. First is the data loading code. This defines the directory for the vector database. The code is quite simple. LangChain provides a PDF file loading interface called pdfloater. It extracts text content from PDF files and generates a list of documents. Then, TextSplitter is used to split the documents. Next is the definition of embedding, where we use GPT for all embeddings. Finally, we call chroma to save the data to the database. By default, when we exit the program, Chroma writes the data to the directory we defined. Now let's run the data loading code. It's all done. Let's take a look at the contents in the directory. Next, let's take a look at the application of this app. It mainly consists of two parts. The first part is the core processing of the large language model, primarily handled by LangChain. When a user sends a question, pre-processing is done, followed by semantic search. The search results are then passed to the QA chain. The QA chain undergoes further processing using the llama configuration we've set and returns the results to the user. The user interaction part is entirely managed by Chainlit, which utilizes asynchronous interactions. Let's delve into the specific code. Here, we fetch the predefined prompt from LangChain. Prompt is a method of providing special response guidance to the large language model, ensuring that it accurately returns the content we expect. We define the large language model we are using, followed by the definition of the QA chain. We need to provide parameters such as LLM, retriever, chain type, etc. A retriever is an interface that returns documents given an unstructured query, and it is more general than in a vector store. Retrieval QA is a predefined chain for question, answering against a vector store. Here, there's a parameter allowing the return of the original document's location. The QA chain completes the assembly and invocation of all components, including word embedding, vector database retrieval, and LM invocation. This is the code defining the robot. We load the database from the specified directory using the same word embeddings as during data loading, namely GPT4L embeddings. We pass the vector database as a retriever, generating the QA chain. Now let's look at the second part. This part of the code is based on Chainlit. Firstly, there's the definition of the startup section of the chat program. Here we define some greeting messages for the users. Then there's the definition of the user question processing section. Since LLM processing usually takes some time, the entire interaction logic is asynchronous. We can see that the entire program's code is very concise. Now, let's launch the entire app. The startup process is complete. Let's take a look at the chat page. You can see that the robot has displayed relevant greeting messages. Now, let's ask a question and see how it responds. Here is one of the results it provided. Chainlit provides a hierarchically structured return result. When expanded, we can see more detailed content. We can observe that this result is obtained from the documents we provided. Now, let's take a look at the back-end logs. The logs provide detailed information about the application's runtime. In conclusion, this is a quick demonstration of creating a chatbot using LLM+RAG technologies, leveraging existing tools and frameworks. The chatbot uses private documents as a data source, understands natural language, and returns responses in natural language. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.